Assalamu alaikum, this is Imran, Intervention Radiology Nurse. Today we are going to demonstrate how to prepare the items for cerebrovascular accident. It is called mechanical thrombectomy also. So we should be very quick and as early as possible we need to prepare our table very fast. Yeah. So first of all we need to prepare this saline bag without any bubbles to prevent any air embolism. For that we have already pressured bag with so much of pressure. So make sure your IV line is without any bubbles. So good that it is ready for without any bubbles. Okay, it is ready now. Now the items what we use is first initial puncture needle. Every item what we are using is we need to flush it properly. So then our short guide wire, make sure that your wire will go into the needle properly. Sometimes the needle gauge will be smaller than the wire, so we need to be make sure so that we won't suffer later on. Then flushing of the sheath. So here I am using 6 inch 5.5 centimeter short sheath, but usually it will be 11 centimeter sheath. For demonstration purpose I am using the small one. So the mechanism is the same. First flush your side port, then sheath. After this close the sheath and check the valve here. Sometimes the valve will be damaged here, so there will be manufacture defect. If you use that one, there will be blood oozing when it is in the inside the body of the patient. Then okay, once it is sealed, then lock it. The arrow should be towards the tube, not towards the side port or towards this. If you put like this, the blood go out. If you put like this, the blood go out. So you should always close. Then flush the dilator. Click it. You see, you should lock it. Then only it is fit for. Then we need 6 French guiding catheter. Usually we are using 6 French Chaperon and 5 French Sophia. It is a long 125 centimeter Sophia catheter. This is also 5 French. So first of all, we will prepare our Chaperon or 6 French guiding catheter. So you need to prepare your Y adapter. So flush it, press it. Now it is ready. So fix it with the guiding catheter, also flush it and lock it. Make sure there is no bubble. This is called fluid filled catheter system. Okay, this is called fluid filled catheter system now. So remove this one, same goes with the Sophia command. Just flush it. Now it is ready. Now we will prepare our microcatheter. For microcatheter, we will use different microcatheters which will fit in the 5 French catheter. So first of all, we will flush this our casing so that the microcatheter will wet inside and it will come out easily. Then put in our basin, take out the micro wire. Dip in your saline so that it will be more hydrophilic for you, it won't slippery. Then hold it, load into the microcatheter. So it is so slippery, so you will be very careful while dealing with the microcatheter and microwire. You see, it is so slippery. So you should hold in a proper way, very near to the end, so that you can feed it very properly. Yes. Now it is ready. And until you use it, just make a loop it and put in your basin. There is a groove here to holding this catheters. And prepare again Y connector for micro catheter. This micro catheter, this Y connector here, we are using screw type. So you will unscrew it so that the valve will open here and the wire will go out. You see, like this, and fix it well. For all this, and this is a torque device. So we will fix it and we will tight it. If you lose it, it will fall down. So it keep close it. Then here, this one always. You will, while pouring water, you will dip it and you will hold it, you see. Then flush the catheter. You can see the catheter is flushing now properly. And close it. Later on, we can control the flow. Now everything is ready. The revascular device we are using here always in the new catheters is Solitaire. Depending on the size of the clot, we will use different sizes of revascularization device. This is Solitaire. Here this is the filter. This is like a filter type. It can catch the thrombus. This is the device. So far it is very costly, so we are not opening this one. So we are just demonstrating this one. Then to puncture needle, guide wire, sheath will go inside the body. After sheath, we will remove this one. So after sheath, our this all will doctor will do. So our catheter will go inside. Then goes our Sophia inside. Okay, once it is there, you should be ready with our micro catheter. So now the micro catheter will go inside our. This is a pressing type Y connector inside it. Okay, alas. Now your doctor reach until the targeted place. Okay, then he will remove the wire. So the wire will goes into our tray. Now we will use here thrombectomy device here. So once the thrombectomy it is in the place, we will keep there for. It is already deployed, so we will keep the stent there for revascular device for 2 to 3 minutes. So after that, your doctor will ask you to aspirate it. So from here, he will say you aspirate, aspirate, aspirate. So you will just plunge it. Just aspirate, 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 aspirate until it lock. Then don't release your plunger. Keep on aspirating. So he will give to you with Sophia command. So you will flush, everything is flushed out, and be ready for another attempt. Okay, one more thing, how to prepare hydrophilic wire. Hydrophilic wire, this is the guiding wire for, you need to flush the casing very slowly. This hydrophilic means water loving yarn. Once it is flushed, now it is ready to go. You see, hold just 2 loops. So give to the doctor like this. This is enough. Okay, and this is the injector. Injector always give the female side to the patient, to the technician, so that he will inject, he will connect to the injector. This end goes into the patient side. So always make sure that it is clamped. Hope you understand. So if any doubts, thank you so much.